In this video, I will talk about how to formulate Go programming problems. All the linear programming problems we have introduced so far have only a single objective function. In real-world applications, we may face multiple conflicting goals, and we may not be able to meet all the goals simultaneously. Go programming provides a way for dealing with such situations. It seeks a solution that minimizes the weighted sum of deviations of these objective functions from their respective goals. In general, there are three types of goals. A lower, one-sided goal sets a lower limit that we do not want to fall under, but exceeding the limit is fine. This corresponds to a greater than or equal to constraint. An upper, one-sided goal sets an upper limit that we do not want to exceed, but falling under the limit is fine. This corresponds to a less than or equal to constraint. A two-sided goal sets a specific target that we do not want to miss on either side. This corresponds to an equality constraint. Let's see an example. A project manager is trying to determine the quantities of three types of products to produce. Producing one unit of product 1 will need 40 employees and 2 tons of raw material, and it will bring the company $5 million of profit. For product 2, these values are 30, 4, and 8. For product 3, these values are 20, 3, and 4. The manager wants to meet these three goals. First, the maximum number of employees that can be allocated to producing these products is 100. Second, there are 10 tons of raw material in the warehouse. The manager wants to consume them all, no more and no less. Third, the total profit is expected to be at least $30 million. The manager realized that it probably will not be able to attain all these goals simultaneously. Therefore, he sets some penalty weights for the unmet goals. If the project needs more than 100 employees, each extra employee is associated with a penalty of 5. This penalty weight is unitless. If the total raw material needed is different from 10 tons, each ton that is below the goal is associated with a penalty of 8, and each ton that is above this goal is associated with a penalty of 12. If the profit is less than $30 million, each $1 million under the goal is associated with a penalty of 15. So the manager wants to minimize the total penalty. Let's define the decision variables. Xi is the amount of product I to be produced. I is equal to 1, 2, and 3. This is the first goal. The total number of employees needed should not exceed 100. This is the second goal. The total amount of raw material should be exactly 10, no more and no less. This is the third goal. The total profit should be at least $30 million. Now let's introduce three variables, Y1, Y2, and Y3. They represent the deviations from the goals. For example, Y1 is equal to the number of employees needed in the project minus the goal, which is the 100 employees. If the needed number of employees is less than 100, then Y1 is a negative number. If the needed number of employees is equal to 100, Y1 is 0. If the needed number of employees is greater than 100, Y1 is a positive number. Therefore, Y1 is an unrestricted sign variable. So are Y2 and Y3. Now let me rewrite these three equations by moving some items to the left-hand side and others to the right-hand side. This is the new form. We introduced in a previous video that if we have an unrestricted sign variable, we need to define two new variables to represent the positive deviation and the negative deviation from the goal, and replace the unrestricted sign variable with the positive deviation minus the negative deviation. Let's do that for these three equations. The manager wants to minimize the total penalty. For the labor, there will be a penalty only if the number of needed employees is over 100. So the penalty is 5 times Y1 plus. For the raw material, there will be a penalty if it is less than 10 tons. There will also be a penalty if it is greater than 10 tons. So the penalty is 8 times Y2 minus plus 12 times Y2 plus. For the profit, there will be a penalty if it is less than $30 million. So the penalty is 15 times y 3 minus. The total penalty is their sum. This is the complete problem formulation. Even though it is unrealistic, we assume the variables can take fraction numbers, so it is a linear programming problem. Otherwise, if some variables must take integers, then this problem is a mixed integer programming problem. For this linear programming problem, we can solve it using the simplex method. This is the optimal solution. It means the manager should decide to only produce 3.33 product 2. The first goal is achieved. He will not need more than 100 employees. The second goal is not achieved. He will need 3.33 tons of more raw material. The third goal is not achieved. The total profit is $3.33 million under the goal. The minimum total penalty for deviating from all three goals is z* is equal to 90. Okay, this is how to formulate good programming problems. Thanks for watching.